my family and I were victims of an F3 tornado. If it looks like I am coming to you from a hotel room, it's because I am. I have insurance, so fortunately the house that I've lived in for 13 years, which is going to have some substantial work done to it, was covered. And so because of that, even though it's not safe to stay in our house now, my family and I, for the last week since it happened, have been staying in hotel rooms. Unfortunately, a lot of my neighbors aren't so lucky. Many didn't have insurance, and even those who did, many had massive amounts of damage. We had some serious damage to our roof, which will need to be replaced, and some structural damage. I find out on Monday I have to have a structural engineer come in and check to see if the foundation was rocked so much that my house needs to be demolished, or if it can be repaired. Regardless, I'm going to be out of my home for either anywhere from 2 months to 8 months. We just got power back at the house today, but again, it's not safe. And that's really hard. And if we don't have a place to stay, I don't know what I'm going to do. But there's a lot of stories coming out about what it's like to live in through a tornado. And I wanted to do this vlog to share the truth and what it's really like. Because what you see in newspapers and you see on TV is only part of the story. It is the sound bites and the quotes and the blurbs that look good for a headline or look good in a story. And reporters try to give you the best picture that they can, but until you've actually been there, you don't know what it's like. Nobody really does. And so I wanted to do this vlog to share my story and the story of others from my neighborhood. So yeah, that's what this is all about.
Hello, right? Hoping everybody, when my toy was safe, then the tornado broke the houses and our roof and everybody's roof. And we have electricity and we went sleep over our bed. Then me and Kayla was having lunch. Then you came. Then we were going back to the hotel. Then we went swimming. Then we went there.
Do you remember what the tornado was like when it actually happened? Where were we?
We were at our house.
Mm-hmm. With who?
My father and grandma. Then the tornado walked, then we were down the basement.
Yeah.
And last but not least, we went out in the basement just to look and see the tornado whole garden.
What did it look like?
By the tornado.
Everything was broke. What did it look like when we came out of the basement?
A jungle.
Looked like a jungle?
Yes.
Yeah.
And a zoo.
And a zoo? Why did it look like a zoo?
Because it had the 10 animals.
You're silly.
Watch where you step. I'm worried. Did you call Alliant and get it shut off?
Tell them
our power's gone. They have to shut it all off.
I will. I think our roof is gone. I know our roof is completely gone. That's why it was pouring down so bad. I'm going to go check our car. I don't know if this is a power line or not, so don't touch it.
Yeah.
I don't think it is, though, but I'm not going to mess with it. Wow, it completely destroyed that phone pole, Allie. Everybody okay over there?
Yeah.
Okay. Smell for gas. Make sure there's no gas leaks. Make sure there's no gas leak. Okay, I know, but smell. Make sure that it doesn't smell like gas over at your house. Okay. Are you guys okay? Okay. Holy cow. This back window's destroyed. Glass all over everything in there. Side window destroyed. Mirror moved. Fence is gone. Holy hell. Somehow my daughter's bike is still okay. Go figure, right? I think everybody in the neighborhood's okay, so that's a plus. My backyard used to have a beautiful fence, and now it's dead. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's my roof. In fact, I know it is. So there's my roof. Take a picture for insurance purposes, I suppose. There's the tree that's been dying for a while, I suppose, right? All right, I gotta call the insurance company. I gotta call Alliant. Both cars have shattered windows, so if we stay at a hotel room, this tree is destroyed. Okay, so come on, Dolores. Backyard is pretty wrecked. My fence, I had a big old privacy fence, it's gone. My car got physically moved, and the driver's side window and the back window are out. Two of Dolores' windows are also out. I've heard that there are live wires and there have been casualties, so I just thank Jesus that we all survived and that everybody in our family is okay. But this was at least an F3 tornado, maybe higher, I don't know. But yeah, look at that. You can see a piece of siding sticking out of our house. The window that we were by in the basement has a piece of wood sticking by it. Look at that. Literally sticking out of the house. So now we're gonna go inside real quick. Glass is shattered. Fortunately, this is pretty much the extent of the damage as far as inside goes. Can't seem to lock my door, which is strange. I don't know what's up with that. It's leaking because of the roof, so I'm gonna have to try and mess with that a little bit. Oh, shit. Okay. Well, yeah. Home and Martha's okay. Say hi, Martha. It literally shook pictures off the walls, and this is sucked inward, which scares the hell out of me. Oh, damn. Okay, well, that window's not broke. I don't know what the hell happened here. I don't know if I think Allie might have tucked that in to make sure that it didn't break, but I'm not going to mess with it. Water's not leaking down the stairs. That's good. Bucket's not having to soak up any more water. That's also good. I'm going to the better bathroom. Oh, that's not as bad as I expected. I thought it would still be dripping. That was pouring down water earlier. Goddamn. This is insane. Fortunately, we were one of the blessed ones. Our house is still somewhat together. Our roof is messed up. But, you know, hey, I'll take that over a destroyed house any day of the week. So, kids' playhouse down there under that. I don't know what we're gonna do. Gotta call the insurance company. Stop vlogging this shit. Now the cleanup begins. We were very fortunate in that there was some structural damage, but it could have been a hell of a lot worse. We broken glass everywhere. I just cleaned off a bunch of the porch. We have no power. Most people don't. It's pretty much evacuated. I don't hear anybody else cleaning up, but it's got to get done. Anyway, thank God we're all alive. And okay. It's part of my fence. We found part of my grill in the neighbor's yard across the street. From my front porch. My neighbors across the street have been working diligently to repair their house. I'm not sure if they're insured or not. In fact, those neighbors over there have been there for 30 or more years, and they've been renters, and they have to move now. They've moved out of state, two states away, actually. So we're seeing skyline we've never seen before and houses we've never seen before because the trees are gone. And there's a brick apartment complex up the block. I've never seen it from my porch before. So, it's been crazy. But this is my view now. Huh. So, it has been about 3 weeks. It's actually been about 23 days since the tornado. As you can see, I am back in my home, but temporarily. And I'm not complaining. Listen, there's a lot of people who don't have homes to return to. So I'm very happy to be here, and I'm very grateful to be here with electricity and air and internet and all that stuff, because our utility workers and cable guys work pretty diligently to make it happen. So we appreciate that. So a little bit of an update. My house obviously doesn't need to be demolished, but what is going to have to happen is some very significant repairs. Like many of the houses affected by the tornado, my roof had to be completely redone. It has been completed yesterday. They finished. It took a day and a half, but they got the roof completely rebuilt, braced, and shingled, and they were amazing. Precision was the contracting company, and they did a phenomenal job, and they were very professional about it, so we appreciated that. There was a lot of debris removal, and there was some help with that. It's just been really crazy. But as far as repairs go, we have to have all of our siding replaced. We have to have many of our windows replaced, all of the screens replaced. All of the internal walls and ceilings have to be repaired, replaced, and painted. It's crazy. There's a lot to be done. So when that happens, we'll have to leave the house for probably a good month or so, and we'll end up staying in the hotel again. But again, I'm very grateful to be home, because there's a little bit of normalcy, and I really missed normal, not for myself, but for my kids. I mean, the lack of normalcy, the lack of the sense of normalcy was the weirdest part about it and the hardest part for me, because my kids struggled. You know, they didn't know what was next, and neither did I. And my wife and I tried so hard to give them some kind of normalcy, and they just didn't have it. And now they do. But I wanted to take a second to say thank you very much for watching this video. There's two more clips after this and a few more pictures, then it's over, I promise. The first clip is an interview, pardon me, with a guy named Tony from Team Rubicon. And the reason I wanted to include this in this video is because one of the most amazing things to me were the volunteers. We had armies, literal armies of volunteers, show up en masse day in, day out. Like 2 days after the tornado, I had a team of 8 Amish guys with 5 chainsaws show up at our house and just say, hey, we noticed your roof is damaged. Would you like us to put some tarps on it free of charge? We noticed you have tons of tree debris. Would you like us to help cut it down free of charge? Just showing that we care. And it was with a thing called Christians Network or something. And it was amazing. I was like, absolutely, you know. These guys just came in. They helped out. They were here for like 4 hours, and they did it. And it was so heartwarming to know that we weren't alone. And I mean, it's so overwhelming and daunting when this happens to you, because there's so much to do, and you know that you don't have the resources, the time, the energy, the money to deal with it. So when volunteers come in and offer their time free of charge, it gives you faith in humanity. That's to say the least. But these Amish guys were from Kelowna, Iowa, and 2 hours away, and came just because they knew there was need. And that's kind of what brings me to Team Rubicon. They were working on some foliage in my neighbor's backyard. And I went over there, and they come from all over the country. One guy was from Texas, one was from Washington State. And you gotta see this interview. So there's gonna be a short interview, and then I drive around my neighborhood a little bit to show you what that looks like, and then there's some still pictures. But I really wanted to make this video so that, you know, we're never gonna forget what happened, those of us that were affected. But I think it's important that people understand that the struggle and the process of rebuilding is ongoing. So I wanted to give people a sense of what that is, what that's like. And so I'm going to continue to chronicle this journey that I and my family are going through. So look forward to more videos. I doubt any of them will be quite this long. To be frank, this video contains things that aren't in any other videos. I didn't share a lot of this because I didn't have internet and the timing wasn't right. I hadn't edited it together the way that I have today. So thank you for taking the time to watch it. And I hope that you find it in your heart to share it if you feel that it was valuable. God bless, Godspeed, and stay strong. Thanks for sticking around.
Hey, how you doing?
So you are with Team Rubicon, disaster response, right?
Yes, I am.
Okay, well, you are one of the many armies of volunteers that's come out and helped us clean up after the storm.
Yep.
So what is Team Rubicon?
Team Rubicon is a nonprofit organization that's primarily made up of veterans, but okay. It's not just veterans. It was founded right after the Haiti incident, the hurricanes that happened down there.
Mm-hmm.
And since then, it's escalated and become a hub of a lot of volunteers that come together. Now we respond to natural disasters all over the world.
That's awesome.
And it's a chance for volunteers from all over the states now to come together and help people that are in need, like here in Iowa.
Sure. So that brings me to my next thing. So we're in Marshalltown, middle of nowhere, Iowa, and you guys have a team. How many people came out with you to this location?
To this location, what we have on the ground right now is 70 people. We have more that are en route
nice.
Over the next few days. We have people that have to go back to their homes because of other requirements.
Life.
Yes, to
yeah, life.
So over the next few weeks, we will have people here as needed, and then
very cool.
Right now, about 70 people.
So you said they come from all over the country. Where are you from?
I'm from Washington State.
Nice. And I talked to one of your associates here who is from California.
Yes, he is.
And so what made you decide to join Team Rubicon?
I'm actually in the military. I'm getting ready to retire next few weeks, and I felt that this was a good transition for me getting out of the military to continue giving back to the community. And
well,
I felt that I'd be able to continue my brotherhood.
Well, as a survivor of an F3 tornado, I can't stress enough how much we appreciate you guys and all that you've done. I mean, this used to be a giant tree that was next to my house, and that's what's left of it because you guys made short work of it. And we appreciate it because a lot of us are trying to get back to our lives, don't know what to do or how to do it, and without volunteers like you, it's impossible. So thank you for your military service. Congrats on your retirement. And thanks for you and your whole team. Thank you for coming out. We really do appreciate it. And thanks for being on my YouTube channel and letting the world know what this is about. So thanks.
Thank you very much, sir.
Appreciate it.
Appreciate it.
Cool.
Smile, though your heart is aching. Smile, even though it's breaking. When there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by. If you smile through your fear and sorrow, smile and maybe tomorrow you'll see the sun come shining through for you. Light up your face with gladness. Hide every trace of sadness. Although a tear may be ever so near, that That's the time you must keep on trying. Smile, what's the use of crying? You'll find that life is still worthwhile if you just smile. On trying. Smile, what's the use of crying? You'll find that life is still worthwhile if you just smile.